Hello friends. So today we are going to talk about these two name reactions, right? So this is an example of Peterson olefination, which is a very known reaction, and this one is an example of Beckmann rearrangement, right? So in Peterson olefination, so there are two conditions, like one in presence of acid and another in presence of base. So what happens in presence of acid and a base? Right. So in presence of acid, the OH group and the SiMH3, when they're antiperiplanar, like they're in opposite plane, they get eliminated. Right. But if we add a base, so what happens? There is a proton abstraction. That means there will be a generation of a negative charge over here. So due to the strong affinity of oxygen for silicon, so this silicon and oxygen comes in one plane, right? So if it comes in one plane, it forms a bond with silicon, and then elimination takes place. So let's start this one. So here what happens, here we have a SiMH3, right? And here we have a OH group, right? Fine. So what happens over here, this gets protonated, like, and these are antiperiplanar. So in presence of acid, it undergoes elimination. So we are ending with transisomer, right? For this case, when we are adding a base, then what happens? Then this OH group and SiMH3 has to come in one plane. So if we rotate this bond, then the OH will go in the back side, right? So how it will look like? It will look like this bond is this one, and this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? Now we have a SiMH3 like this, and this OH becomes like this. Okay, fine. Now we are adding a base, so there is a proton abstraction, and this this oxygen and silicon bond takes place. This oxygen attacks this silicon intramolecularly. So in order to attack, it must have to be in the same plane or same side. So it attacks here, and this forms a bond, right? So we are ending with a cis-isomer. So let's if there is like if we have a different substrate, just one thing, don't try to mug up this, like only the this configuration will give trans and this will give cis. Not like this. Means just try to make the silicon just try to focus on the SiMH3 of the silicon group and the OH group. If they are antiperiplanar, if we add up acid, then the system will be like this. It will not change. But if we add a base, then the system will change. Means the in order to give this OH at the back side, we have to rotate this bond, right? So this is the example of Peterson olefination. Right? Okay. So next we will move on to the Beckmann rearrangement. And so what happens in Beckmann rearrangement? So you have given this substrate and you have given a tosyl chloride and pyridine. So what happens over here? So phenyl, this is the methyl, this is hydrogen, this is our methyl, okay? So OTS, okay? Now OTS is a very good leaving group, right? So what happens here? The rearrangement takes place. So this group will migrate. This group will migrate, and this helps the OTS to leave the system. So if this group migrates, whole group migrates, then OTS will leave. So what we are getting? We are getting N, and I think this one. Now think about the stereochemistry. So for this any rearrangement type reaction, this there is a retention of configuration. So if we start with a R isomer, so we will end up with R isomer only. So there will not be any change in the stereochemistry of this chiral center. So this is a chiral molecule. Okay. So there is no change in stereochemistry of this chiral center. So phenyl was in the back side, methyl in the front side. So that will be reflected in the product also. That in the product also will get phenyl at the back side, methyl at the top side, and like hydrogen. Right. So retention of configuration. Any types of rearrangement reaction, always there is a retention of configuration, right? So as it migrates, so there is a positive charge, generation of positive charge. Fine. So I am drawing it over here. So we have this, let's say R group. We are writing it as, writing that R group, right? So it's the R group, and here we have a positive charge. Sorry, here we have the N atom. Okay. Now we have the hydrolysis condition. So water, we are adding water. Basically, we are adding water. Water adds here. Okay. So what happens? R group. So it's basically forming this one. So this undergoes ketoenol tautomerism. Right. So it will abstract this proton. So we will basically get this is ketone, it's Na, and this is our R group. Like we have a hydrogen, this is methyl, this is phenyl. So this is our product. So just try to remember the group which will migrate will remain, will be attached to the N group, and this will become the center from which it gets migrated. That center, the earlier where the this group was there, and that center becomes a keto center. So this is the example of Beckmann fragmentation. So you will get lots of example in Claydon as well as in Caruthers about the Beckmann rearrangement as well as the Peterson olefination, and I will come up with more examples of this kind of reactions. So that's all for the video, and thanks for watching.